Today, we are going to know about how to know the will of God. How do I know the will of God? Many of us might be in a confused situation. How do I know the will of God? What is the will of God in my life? What is the will of God? Do I have the will of God in my life? Or is there something called the will of God in my life? So for us to understand that, I would like everybody to refer to this verse, Romans chapter 12, verse 2. This is what it says. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will. What do we see here? We see few statements. We see one verse with many statements. And we see all these elements with the following statements. The first one is, there is a will of God, which is very good, which is pleasing, which is also perfect. There is a perfect will of God. And now, so in order for us to know that if there is a will of God, then is there a will of God over your life? Right? Is there a will of God over your life? Do I have the will of God over my life? That's a basic question which everybody wants to know. So we, as young teenager or as a young child, we always would like to enter this world with great enthusiasm. We always enter this world with great, with great thoughts, with great ideas. But down the lane, something happens. We consult our parents in order for us to know what should we do. Or we consult our aunts, our uncles. We consult our friends, you know. We consult different people, or we go to different sources in order for us to know about the life or the will of God over my life. In order for us to know the will of God over your life, the first person that you need to go to is God. Do not forget that He is the reason why you are breathing. He is the reason why you are living. My dear friends, today I would like to talk to you about how should you know the will of God. But the first point before to know how, you need to know, is there a will of God over your life? And when we ask that question, is there the will of God over my life? The first history that I want you to refer to is, before Adam, there was nothing. Adam was the first man. Before Moses, there was no savior for Israel. Moses was the first man. Before Saul, there was no king over Israel. I mean, the physical king over Israel, right? Israel had the first king in the form of Saul. And we see that there were many first things or first people who did many things, right? Till the time Thomas Edison came, there was no bulb, right? Or there were not many things till many people came. So the first point you need to understand is, there is always the will of God over your life. There is always a will of God over your life. But that will need not necessarily be the same will like the other people. Got it? Like, just because your friend is great in maths, you need not be great in maths. Just because your person whom you know is doing really good in life, you need not do really good in finances. Got it? So your life might be different from your friends. The way you behave is different. Your design is different. The way you think is different. The way you observe things is different. The way you absorb things is different. For example, you might be the same person who's listening to this message, but your friend might receive this message in a different way. There are different, everybody is different in this whole wide world. Everybody, all the 700 crore people who are there right now in this world, everybody is different, my dear brother, my dear sister. Everybody is different. So your will need not be the same like your friends. All right, so now let's go to the main point. The second question is, how do I find the will of God over my life? How do I find the will of God over my life? Well, brother, if there is the will of God over my life, how do I find it? How do I find it? Well, we can see the verse. We can learn from the Bible, the very statement that we just read right now. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, right? How? Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. That means God's will is there, but in order for you to discover God's will, you need to test and approve. You need to test. Everybody, listen to this word carefully. It is called T-E-S-T, test. You got to test. You got to test every will over your life. I'm telling you, you for example, you'll only be able to test and know whether it's God's will in your life. How? You can ask me how. Well, for example, if you're interested towards cricket, rather than sitting back home and thinking, will I be able to achieve great heights in cricket? Will I be able to do great things in cricket? It is better for you to join an institute, a cricket training institute, and know whether you are fit for cricket or not, right? Until and unless you go and test yourself in that field, I'm telling you, you will not be able to know. So this is exactly what God is saying. You got to test and approve what God's will over your life is. You got to first of all, join the cricket institute. You got to go and first of all, join whatever interests you naturally. You got to go and do the things that interest you naturally. And when you're drawn towards it, I'm telling you, you can be successful if that is the will of God over your life. Well, brother, if I'm not able to withstand the pressure of cricket over my life, what do I do? Well, you can try some other field. You can try something else which you're naturally drawn towards. Is music your field? Or is camera work your field? Or is interior designing your field? What is your field? What is that you are naturally drawn towards? Just because you are naturally drawn towards one thing need not necessarily be the will of God. That can just be an interest. I'm telling you, interest is different from the will of God. Interest means that can interest you for some time, and after that you get bored over it, and then you choose a different path. But the will of God is not like that. The will of God is something that wakes you up when you sleep. The will of God is something which cannot be taken away from you. Like, for example, if you're really interested in cricket, you will be dreaming of cricket even when you're sleeping. You will be talking about cricket to your friends. You'll be, even when you're having lunch, you'll be observing the cricket matches. You'll be observing how each and every player is bowling or batting or fielding or holding or catching. I'm telling you, will is totally different from interest. Don't get confused between the will and the interest. So the will of God, you got to test in order for you to be approved of the will of God. Go through the fire, go through the hardships. If you are scared to go through the hardships, you are never going to discover the will of God. If you are scared to not know the things, see, when we read the word test is not something which is easy. Test is hard. Test is difficult. Test is not something you prepare for the test, man. Test doesn't happen naturally. You prepare for the test. Every person who's waiting is actually preparing for the test. If you're waiting for something in your life, you're not sitting idle and you're not just relaxing. You're actually preparing yourself. And the word of the Lord says, those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. How do you renew your strength? When you're preparing for the test, you don't sit idle and prepare. You prepare it mentally, you prepare for it physically. For example, you gain as much knowledge as you can during the waiting time. You gain as much information as you can during the waiting time. I'm telling you, the waiting time determines your approval rate in the test. Your waiting time, what you do in the waiting time determines your approval rate in the test. So start at a very young age. Start at a very young age. Don't wait. Don't wait till you are 25. Don't wait till you are 21. Most folks, this is what they do. They wait. They follow the pattern of the world. That's exactly what the Bible verse says. Do not conform yourself to the pattern of the world. That means do not behave like everybody else. Do not think like everybody else. Now that draws us to the third point, that is, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. When you think about this, well, if you are interested in cricket, you go join a cricket institute, right? So, but when you go join the cricket institute, your skill level will be at one place. Your skill level will be at a very basic place. You cannot take that skill level and go play for the national Indian national cricket team. If you got to play for the Indian national cricket team, your skill level needs to be upgraded. That's exactly what the verse says. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Well, you got to renew your mind. And when you renew your mind, that's when you can transform yourself from a basic skill level to an upgraded skill level. You got to renew your mind. You got to start thinking like nobody else. You got to start focusing on things like how nobody else has done till now. My dear brother, how are you focusing your life on? Or are you focusing on the will of God enough so you can grow in the will of God? So you can grow in the will of God. My dear brother and sister, if you're watching this video today, I challenge you to accept every challenge that comes in your life. Accept every challenge that comes in your life. Is it being too late at your workplace? Accept that. Is it being too late at your coaching center? Accept that. When you accept the challenge, that is when the people are going to pass with flying colors. Because if you don't accept, how will you be tested? If you don't accept, how can you be tested? You cannot be tested till you accept. So, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You always need to constantly renew your mind. Who are you currently? And whom do you want to be? Who are you currently? And whom do you desire to be? Well, if you're a musician, do you desire to be the best musician in the world? If you're an editor, do you desire to be the best editor in the world? If you're a cameraman, if you're an interior designer, do you desire to be the best interior designer or the best cameraman in the world? If you desire to be the best coder, the best website designer, are you spending enough time for you to be tested? Are you challenging yourself? I'm telling you, every entrepreneur, that they always challenge themselves. The challenge that other people give is nothing, because they constantly challenge themselves. They constantly renew themselves. They don't, you know, when you talk about renewing your mind, that means leaving your old habits, leaving your old traditions, leaving your old culture, accepting the new ways, treading the new paths, treading the new things. I mean, you just face it with boldness. Just because nobody was a king, if Saul would have denied being a king, he would never had been the first king of Israel. If Moses denied saying, God, I never saw somebody saved. I never saw somebody being saved. How can I redeem Israel from Egypt? Well, there would have never been a Moses, and we would have never spoken about Moses. Remember, it is because of what Moses did, we know the history of Moses now. If Moses would have never accepted the challenge, if Moses would have never been in the perfect will of God, there would have never been a great Moses that we are talking today. The fourth point that I want to talk to you, and this is the last and final point that I want to talk. The fourth point is, how can you transform yourself? How can you transform yourself? I understood if there is will of God over my life, yes. I understood how to understand the will of God, yes, that's very good. I understood that in order for us to accept the will of God, we need to renew our minds. That's also very good. But how can I transform myself? How can I transform myself? If you look at the eagle, it transforms itself. It breaks its own beak. Whatever comes in its way, in order for it to be successful, it always shatters it down, even though it's its own body. I'm telling you, my dear brother and sister, you can say, I have determined where I want to go. I have determined who I want to be. Now, how do I get the highest level of excellence? How do I get the highest level of excellence? That is your path for transformation. How do I get through renewing your mind again? You can be transformed when you renew your mind. Remember, the first thing that you got to change if you want to grow to greater heights is to change your mind. Change the way you think. Change the way things happen. The first thing is you need to change the way you think. If you don't change the way you think, how do I change the way I think? Well, you can change the way you think by changing what you hear. You can change the way you think by changing what you see. You can change the way you think by changing what you talk. I'm telling you, transformation is not easy. Transformation is not easy. There is always obstacles. For example, when you look at the life of Eve, you know, till the time the fruit was there, but the fruit was never attractive. The fruit was never pleasing to the eye. She was in the right mind with God, but what changed her pattern of thinking? What changed the way she thought? The words that entered her mind. The words that entered the mind of Eve. Satan asks Eve, did God tell you really not to eat the fruit? You know what happens when you eat the fruit? When you eat the fruit, you become like God. The very fact is, she was already like God. She need not become like God. But this is exactly what the world tries to do. The world tries you to be fixed to one pattern. That's the reason why Romans 12:2, it says, do not be conformed to the world. When you look at the word conformed means to follow the same pattern of the society, to follow the same behavior of the society, just to do how things are normally done. Just to be in the same behavioral pattern. Well, Pastor, everybody buys new clothes for Christmas. Everybody celebrates. That's the reason why I buy and I celebrate. Well, you need not really buy new clothes for Christmas. That is the pattern of the world, my dear brother. That is the pattern of the world, my dear sister. Do not be conformed to the pattern of the world. That's exactly what the Bible says. That means if you're poor and broken, you need not buy new clothes for Christmas. If you're poor and broken, you need not spend that extra money on looking good. If you're poor and broken, the very first thing that you need to concentrate and understand is your very own mind needs to be changed. For this Christmas, can you gift yourself something? The best gift that you can give to yourself is renewing your mind, renewing the pattern of your thinking. Don't behave normally. Every person, every great leader that we see today, if he would have behaved normally, if he would have thought normally, he would have never achieved the great heights that they achieved. What are you willing to give up? Are you willing to give up your comfort zone? Are you willing to give up? Are you ready to sacrifice your time? We all have these great dreams, right? We all always do have these great dreams. But in order for these great dreams to be achieved, you got to do greater things. You got to do greater sacrifices. You got to spend time, more time in learning. The reason why you have been struggling with your life from the past few years is because you thought you wanted to change, but you really never accepted the change in your life. You thought you spoke about change. You thought you would change. Every Sunday, you might go to church, listen to the pastor. But you know what? If you never really took that word into your heart, everything is going to remain the same. Nothing is going to really change. My dear brother, my dear sister, What are you doing in your life today? Are you transforming your life? Are you renewing your mind? Or are you sticking to the pattern of this world? The word of the Lord says, do not conform yourself to the pattern of this world. That means do not stick to the very normal behavior. Do not think like, oh, well, I got to first do my, first pass my 10th class, then do my intermediate, then do my degree or engineering or doctor, and that's when I can find myself a job. And you know what? This is the testimony that you will have when you die. The testimony is, he was really good. He did fine. He just paid his bills and died. Do you want to have the testimony today? Everybody that you look at, all they do is they pay their bills and they die. But don't die in that way. When you die, let people talk great about you. Leave a mark in this world. Leave a mark in this world where people are going to remember you, like how we remember Thomas Alva Edison, like how we remember Albert Einstein, like how we remember Moses, like how we remember Paul, like how we remember Jesus Christ. All these great men, they never were afraid to leave their comfort zone. Being changed is different from thinking to change. Being changed is different from accepting yourself saying that, well, I heard this message, he spoke about change, and this is really good. Now, today is going to be the day where you are going to change. You got to start thinking like that. Well, every day, probably I'm sleeping at 10 o'clock in the night, or every day I'm sleeping by 11 o'clock in the night. You got to change your habits. Maybe I'm going to spend some time reading. I'm going to spend some time browsing the internet, learning new stuff. All these years, probably I have spent enough time looking at other people's profiles, looking at other people's photos and all that, or listening to a lot of sermons. If you spend your time listening to a lot of sermons, when do you have the time for you to implement those changes? My dear brother, if you're ready to change, you got to start changing your habits. You got to start changing the way you dress. You got to start changing the way you talk, the way you listen. What are the words that you listen? What are the thoughts that are going into your mind? So this is what the word says again. Let me remind this. Do not conform yourself to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by renewing your mind. Be transformed by renewing your mind. And that is when you are going to know the perfect, good will of our Lord. When you know the perfect will of our God, you will have struggles, but the struggles will seem nothing. You will fly like the eagle, even in the high altitude. Flying in the high altitude is really difficult. But you know what? Once you go up, you are away from the world. You are focused on only one thing. I'm telling you, if cricket is your focus, if kabaddi is your focus, if music is your focus, if maths is your focus, if science, being a doctor is your focus, or if heart, you like healing people, talking about heart and what the condition of that heart, or do you know, the specializations are getting even more crazy. Now people are doing specialization in one pipe of the heart, one artery of the heart. Man, how are you thinking? Are you still going after that job? Are you still thinking like how people think? Or are you thinking like an entrepreneur? Are you thinking like an entrepreneur? You might be doing a job, but if you don't start thinking like an entrepreneur, you're only going to be stuck doing the job for the rest of your life. I don't want you to be stuck doing a job for the rest of your life. I don't want you to be broke. I don't want you to be poor. I want you to leave a mark when you die. Don't think about living. Think about dying. How do I die in this world. This is how I want to die. I want to die leaving a mark in this world. If you also have the same passion that you want to die leaving a mark in this world, then talk to God and say, God, I'm ready to be changed. I'm ready to be changed. Oh God, shake me. Stop all the ways that I want to go through. Let there be a nice green pasture. But even before you give me the green pasture, test me. Test me. Are you ready to be tested? Until and unless you are ready to be tested, the change will never occur. So with this word, I want to once again remind and leave you with a great thought. Always remember, change is important in order for your life to be changed. Change is important in order for your life to be changed. Thank you. God bless you.